Hello, my name is Brian. In this video, we're going to walk through the setup steps in order to enable the Oracle AI Apps for ERP feature called Intelligent Account Combination Defaulting. First, I'll go through a short introduction of the feature, just to remind everyone what Intelligent Account Combination Defaulting does. Then we'll go through the setup steps that are necessary to enable data ingestion, which triggers the machine learning model training. I'll then show you how to opt into the feature for use within Oracle ERP Cloud. And then finally, we'll go through some basic best practices for testing the feature. Okay, let's briefly go over what Intelligent Account Combination Defaulting does. When processing non-PO invoices, a payables clerk will have to enter the code combination in the distribution combination field. Here we're looking at the Create Invoice screen for an invoice, and you see the distribution combination field highlighted in yellow. Now, without this feature, a payables clerk would have to type in the code combinations, and it's a very mundane task, typically takes a long time, involves a lot of keystrokes, and is very error-prone. So it turns out this is a very good process to involve artificial intelligence and machine learning. So let's talk about how the machine learning works. We start with historical data, which is used to train the machine learning algorithms. We typically use about 18 months if historical data, if it's available. During training, the algorithms see how previous invoices had been processed with code combinations in the past. Usually within 24 hours after data ingestion begins, we get a trained machine learning model. Then in production, when a new invoice is entered, the machine learning models predict each segment and decide whether to default it if the prediction meets a pre-calculated confidence threshold. Once the invoice is processed, the validated segments are then fed back into the model for continuous training on a daily basis. Okay, let's move on now to how we set up Intelligent Account Combination Defaulting in a test or production environment. The first step is to create a BIP user and role and assign some roles. And the first role we're going to assign is the Application Implementation Consultant role. We're going to assign this role to a user that will be the administrator to this feature. So we'll go into the Security Console under Tools, select Security Console. Then we're going to search for the user that we want to assign this role to. So we'll select the user, and then we'll edit this user, and then click Add Role. And we want to add the Application Implementation Consultant role. So we'll search for that. It's the top one. Select it. Click Add Role Membership. And then Done. And we can save and close this. Now what this does is to the user you assigned this role, when they go to their Tools panel, there'll be a quick link. AI Apps Administration. When they click on that, it brings you to a landing page with all the AI features, and you select the first one, AI Apps for ERP, and it brings you to the connections page, which we're going to do in the second step. But before that, we need to create the AI Apps BIP role and the AI Apps BIP user. So again, we're going to go to Tools and the Security Council, but one of the first steps we want to do is we want to create a user category with a password that doesn't expire, because if the password expires, then the data ingestion will stop. So we're going to edit the user categories and create one. You can call it anything you want, AI Apps BIP, put a description if you'd like. Then we create that category, we can save and close, and then we need to edit the password policy to this category. So we'll edit password policy, and the first field is the expiration field. We can type 9,999 days as the top, and that's 27 years and 5 months, so that's plenty. Now the password won't expire for that user, and data ingestion will continue. So we have that category created. Now let's create the AI Apps BIP role. So we'll go to roles, and we'll create that role name, and it's the same for the role code, AI Apps BIP role. Now I'm going to get an error here because I've already created this for this environment. You won't have that. I'm just going to add an extra number to that. Then we add the role category of BI Abstract Roles. And we're going to click Next 3 times to get to the fourth step role hierarchy. And we're going to add some roles underneath this role. So we're going to add a role, and we want to add the BI Author role. So we'll search for BI author. There it is. Select it. Add role membership. And then we want to add another role, the BIP data model developer role. So we'll search for that. There it is. Select it. Add role membership. And we can cancel out of there. We see those roles have been added. And then we want to click next three more times to get to the end. And then we can save and close. We'll get confirmation that the role was created. Now we need to create the user to assign this role to. Now you can use any user, but we recommend you create this dedicated AI Apps BIP user. So again, we're going to add a user account and we're going to type in AI Apps BIP for the user. Same for the name. Now remember this password that you put because you're going to need this later. It's important. And then don't forget to assign the user category that we created, the AIA BIP, so the password won't expire. And then we need to add a role. We need to add the AI Apps BIP role that we just created. So we'll search for that. Select it and add role membership. Okay, and click done. Then we can save and close out of this. And now we need to import the users and the roles that we created. And to do that, we go into Tools and Scheduled Processes, and we need to schedule a new process. And we're going to import the user and role. Search for that. It's the Import User and Role Application Security Data Process. Click OK, and then Submit. And it's a good idea to copy down that process ID because then we can go into the search field and determine when that process has finished running. So we'll type in the ID, click search, and we see that the process is running. It'll take a few minutes. You can refresh the screen, and after a few minutes, you'll see that it succeeded. And now we can move on and connect AI apps to business intelligence. So to do that, we'll go to Tools, click on that AI apps administration link that we went to before, get to the connections page, and then click connections. These fields are filled in. They'll be blank for you if you haven't performed setup before. Don't concern yourself with Oracle Financials Cloud. That's for dynamic discounting. What we need to concern ourselves with right now is Oracle Business Intelligence. We'll edit these fields. Again, they'll be blank for you, but we're going to type in the AI Apps BIP user that we created, the password that we created. And then for the URL, this is your Fusion URL. You can go to your Fusion screen and copy everything up to the .com and paste it there and then save it. If you're in a test environment, you'll also see the P to T refresh date. And it's important that we set that because the models will train on that. The last couple of months of data that we ingest, we use it to evaluate the models. So update training data. Here I'm just going to cancel because it's already filled in. And then you'll see it below that, Oracle Data Science, the models are not trained yet. And so your models will train within 3 to 24 hours, depending on how much data there is. And after the training is done, you'll see an indication that it's trained. And then you can click download report and you'll get a PDF report that shows you every segment in your chart of accounts and the expected coverage and accuracy rate. So for example, segment one will default that 100% of the time with 100% accuracy. Your segment two, 80% of the time with 98.9% accuracy. You'll also see a link to an FAQ document, which may be very handy, and a promotion code, which we're going to need for the next step, which is the feature opt-in. Now, up until this point, we've just done data ingestion, but to use the feature, we need to opt in, and we first need to enter the promotion code. So under My Enterprise, under Enterprise, click Manage Promotion Codes on the left-hand side, click there, and then we can enter the promotion code. And we're going to enter the promotion code that we saw on our evaluation report, and save and close. And you'll see on the list of features that intelligent defaulting of accounting information for supplier invoice promotion code is there. Now we can click done. And now we need to opt into the feature. So we'll go into My Enterprise and Setup and Maintenance. And then we'll change the setup area to Financials. And then under Payables, we'll click the arrow and we'll see a Change Feature Selection button. You can also go to Change Feature Option in the front, but we went this way. And you'll see Intelligent Account Combination Defaulting for Invoices there. We can click the Enable button there and then click Done. And now we're ready to test the feature. We'll just talk about a few best practices for testing. We'll log into the system as a Payables clerk and create an invoice. It's important to test with production-like data. So type in an invoice exactly like you would have in production, or import it through IDR exactly like you would in production. And in the line information, the description field typically is to the right here. We like to move it to the left. We recommend that because people tend to work from left to right. And it's important to input as much data as possible before we invoke the prediction service. So we'll type in the amount, and then we'll type in the description. And then to invoke the prediction, you either tab or click into the distribution combination field, and you'll see a prediction was triggered, and the yellow box is an indication that the AI service was called. And we won't overwrite that prediction, but in order to trigger it again, you can delete it. And if you wanted to change some of the information, the description or amount or whatever, you can delete it, click out, and then click back in, and that will re-trigger the prediction. And again, the yellow box is an indication. Now let's input another invoice for a different supplier, because there are times where you won't get a full prediction. So for example, if we type in the amount for this supplier and the description for this invoice and trigger the prediction again, in this case, we'll get a partial prediction. So we'll only get 4 of the 6 segments. You still see the yellow box indicates that the service was called. And all we need to do now is just input 2 segments instead of 6. So we're still saving quite a bit of time. So in summary, what we want to do is relocate that field, the description field, to the left so that we can enter as much data as possible before we invoke the prediction service. We want to replicate production-like invoices. So use the same suppliers, amounts, descriptions. The header and line information should be as similar as possible as you did in production, because that's what the models were trained on. So don't use an accurate amount such as a dollar, and don't put descriptions like test, because the models will get confused or they won't have the highest confidence, won't get the best results. And also, if possible, replicate the invoice source. So if you imported invoices in production from IDR, use that, or if they're a manual, use that, because that's one of the data features we use to train the models. And you'll get best results if you replicate that. But that's all there is to it to test it. And we hope that you enjoy using this feature. And we thank you for watching the video.